So when we think about feedback, a lot of times we think about feedback that is associated with corrective issues. So I don't want to call it negative feedback, but that's how it can feel to some people. But what about the role of positive feedback in hospitals and on hospital teams? And is it important? Studies have suggested and found that it is highly important. They found that 67% of employees whose managers provided positive feedback were fully engaged in their jobs. When they looked at managers who only provided negative feedback, the corrective feedback to their teams, they found that only 31% of them were fully engaged. Quite frankly, I'm amazed it's even that high. If all you hear about are what's not working well, and you never get those pats on the back, it's amazing that 31% persevered through that. So there's a couple of things that we can do as leaders to give great positive feedback. The first is that we need to be careful and be aware of our nonverbals. In studies, employees who received negative feedback given in a good-natured manner reported feeling better about themselves than employees who received positive feedback given with mixed signals or poor nonverbal cues. And the reason is that 93% of communication is nonverbal. So we as humans are wired to read those nonverbal cues as our primary source of taking information in about our environment. And when those nonverbal cues are saying one thing and verbally we're hearing something else, we are going to believe those nonverbal cues. So be very aware of your eye contact, your facial expressions, your tone of your voice, the pitch of your voice, how loud your voice is, and how rapidly you're speaking. And make sure that if you're trying to give positive feedback, that you're conveying that in a really positive manner. The second thing that's really important is to catch our employees at their best. And that means looking around and seeking out the things that we take for granted in their daily performance. I had an employee that was from another country, and she is now, I'm proud to call her a colleague, a doctor, but at the time she was a certified tech, and she had the most lovely demeanor on the phone. She was kind and she was thoughtful on the phone when she was leaving messages or talking to clients, and I happened to hear her on the phone around the corner from my office one day and came out and said, "Thank you so much. You know, I can only imagine how great the clients must feel when they hear your kind and caring voice over the phone." She loved that positive feedback. Had I done that in front of the entire group, she would have melted in a puddle on the floor because she did not seek public feedback. I have had other employees who break out the streamers and the bands and give them the positive praise. They really like it in a highly public fashion. So seek out what your employees are doing. Look for the opportunities to give positive feedback in the moment and in front of everyone else, depending on the preference of the person that will be receiving the feedback.